So the next in this series of working party videos for developing the Pizzazz program, it's time now to start looking more closely at the abacus, the specific idea, metaphor, and the specific software that I think we can use to take us on to the next stage in developing an assessment framework, an assessment tool. But before we go on to this, I just wanted to take a brief moment to thank all the members of the working party who have contributed ideas and suggestions and so on. I'm very well aware that everybody is really, really busy. I'm aware as well this is a really quite hugely complicated task and a quite convoluted process to actually get somewhere more meaningful. I've had a lot of very positive response to the new framework, and I'm very glad of that, and I'm glad of all those people who've contributed their own ideas and suggestions and thoughts, including thoughts about where we go with this now, what we need to do now to clarify. So I thought this was a good time to sort of just check in and say thank you so much for all of your efforts. It's very much a sort of consultative approach, and in the end it's my ideas and my putting it together, and no one's responsible for it, etc. But it's been really, really encouraging to have a lot of people helping. I was thinking about this a little bit, and I found myself thinking, I had to hire a car a few weeks or so ago, even with an automatic clutch. And automatic clutch takes a little getting used to. Anything new takes a little getting used to. An automatic clutch is designed to make it so easy to change the gear that you don't even think about it. You're not even aware of it happening. But the process of designing an automatic clutch must have been incredibly complicated. Even the process of deciding that it's a good idea to spend the time doing that must have taken quite a leap of the imagination to think, yes, we think we can do it, and we think there'll be a demand for it. And I think in some ways, those of you who helped with the working party, we've been doing all the work of designing the automatic clutch so that other people will be able to not have to think about it at all. So it's a really difficult thing to take on, particularly when you've already got a day job. The other metaphor I was toying with at some point was that of a zoo. I have to be careful with zoo metaphors, let alone interspersing with Blue Planet videos and so on. But designing a zoo is a really incredibly complicated task. Not only have you got the lives and lifestyles of the animals and their own needs and then the viewing positions, but you need the cafeteria and the ticket queues and then the roads and the toilets and fire exits, and a hugely complicated task to make it possible for some people to come and see the animals in the zoo. Managing a zoo is in some ways much more complex. You don't have to do the design, you just work with the design you've got. But at the same time, you've got to work out not just roughly how the traffic flows can work, but specifically which bollards to put where. You've got to work out the supply chains for the ice creams and all the HR issues involved with running a zoo, and exchanges and research programs and so on. And by comparison, if you're a giraffe, say, all you've got to do is just kind of look around you and be a giraffe. I'm told giraffes are actually quite intelligent and very curious creatures. They are more inquisitive. Likewise, camels, llamas, they're all the same family, apparently. So, here's me. I've been trying to design a zoo, and getting help from all you folk out there who've already got zoos of your own to run. So, rather a convoluted metaphor, I'm sure you'll agree. But I just wanted to take this moment with a little bit of kind of impish humour, as always, to thank everybody who's got us so far. We now go on to the next stage of looking to see how we can use the abacus. I myself, when I came across it, thought this is brilliant. This does so many of the things we need to do, but there's other things that it doesn't do. There's other things which are quite complex and challenging, and I'm going to need some help and advice to work out how we get the best out of this. For that matter, if once we got this far, if anyone can see a simpler, better way of doing it, and I've just got sucked into this idea, but if anyone can look at this and say, oh, look, why don't we just do that? Then please do come up with any other simpler ideas. But for now, a little vote of thanks to everybody who's got us so far. If you think that bit was the difficult bit, things have to get worse before they get better, don't they? Translating this now into the abacus, this is really the, I hope, final stages. But I'm always thinking that things will be quicker than they were. But that's the task now. We've got our new framework. Let's first look at how the abacus is set up to work. And then we can see what strength it's got. And we can also see what difficulties, what challenges, where is it that we've actually got to come up with a new thinking to make this work for us, to adapt it, to customise it for the pioneers of the world.